ngayon because of Christmas. Basta sama ng loob, hindi naman masama yun. Pwede rin naman tayong lumapit sa ibang tao at humingi. And that's what I felt here. Like, everyone just felt like, everyone felt safe. And that's what I felt also. So thank you so much for having me here. God, kasi I really have my morning meditation practice. I wake up from between 4 to 5 a.m. And I make sure, especially I started it this June, na every morning when I wake up, I don't get my phone right away. I go to my altar, and then I do my rituals, I meditate. And even on mornings na ayaw ko, alam ko kasi I'm doing it for God. And pag tinamad ako, baka ano sabihin niya sa akin, sabihin niya, hindi ka na grateful. Basically, it's my devotional practice. So people often ask me, what keeps me motivated? I have nothing else to answer but God. Because He is the reason why we're here. And especially after everything that I've been through, I think alam naman mostly ng mga tao kung ano na yung napagdaanan ko, I think. I live a very public life, and it's not easy to live this kind of life. So because of all of the trauma and all of the challenging experiences that I had no choice but to hold on to God. So I hit rock bottom in my life. And ever since I started connecting and developing a very deep and personal relationship with God, siya talaga ang bumabangon sa akin umaga. So I would say, if as long as you keep a solid relationship with God, He will wake you up every morning. And not just in the morning, but He will keep waking you up throughout the day. Because sometimes we fall asleep, we fall back to sleep, we go into autopilot, you know, we become robot. For me, it's being at peace with yourself. Because I used to experience inner war with myself. Because I didn't forgive myself for my past mistakes and my past failures. And it was really like an inner struggle. Kaya inner harmony happens when you finally do the work of going within, facing what you need to face, and forgiving yourself first and foremost. For me, I don't know about any of you, but for my healing journey, I had to start by forgiving myself. Because ang problema ko before, which got me to my healing journey anyway, is my anger management problems. Meron ka rin ba? It's really something that you experience, especially pag hindi mo nadideal ng tama yung emotions mo. That's why we explode into different episodes of anger, irritability, rage. Umaabot pa tayo sa ganun, di ba? So what happened with me was, I really had to quiet down the noise and finally accept my past and forgive my... Tapos na eh. Wala na akong magagawa. And I realized in my healing journey is no matter how much I cry about the past or I feel ashamed, it's not doing me any good because it's actually lowering my vibration. So, alam kong ako yung may kasalanan ng lahat ng ginawa ko in the past. So now in the present moment, pag iniisip ko lahat yon and I'm thinking, nakakahiya ako, ano ba, ba't ko ginawa yun? How is that helping me now? Diba? But if I accept that I was still immature at that time, I was still very young, I was naive, I was not yet as conscious as I am now. So why do I have to punish myself? Why do I have to be so hard on myself? In my healing journey, I realized I only have myself. At the end of the day, all I have is myself. So I needed to forgive myself and to be best friends with myself. And what do you do when you talk to your best friend, di ba? Sinasabihan mo siya, uy, masyado ka na, or I think you're doing too much, or I think hindi mo ginagawa yung kailangan mo gawin. That's how we should be talking to ourselves also, with love, with kindness. And kapag kailangan rin natin pagalitan yung sarili natin, we have to do that, but not naman in an unhealthy way. It's more of, you're actually parang reminding yourself of what you need to do. And I think the sooner we start this, the more we will be able to grow and not waste any more time. Diba? So forgiveness, this is how I achieved inner harmony. And I wouldn't say that inner harmony is something that once ma-achieve mo, nandiyan na siya forever. You have to work on it every day, which means we have to balance ourselves every day. So inner harmony, I would say, is being at peace with yourself, being at peace with who you are. Kasi sometimes the suffering happens when we keep forcing ourselves to be somewhere else, when we are actually here, right now. So make peace with yourself, with who you are, where you are now, and make peace with the present moment. That, for me, is what's going to bring you inner harmony. I believe that everything happens for a reason. I know it sounds cheesy, but it really does happen for a reason. And I also believe, this is something that I learned in Bali, that everything is in perfect order. Everything. God is always behind everything, what's happening in this world. And what happened to me was, that's a funny story, I went to Bali for a teacher training. My first teacher training for yoga was in Thailand.
Best practices.
Okay. I call this pranayama, which is breathing control technique. And you can research about it, there are many different kinds. But whenever I'm feeling overwhelmed, my favorite is to sit and to breathe. It's called box breathing. Inhale for 4, exhale for 4. And then after a few rounds of that, inhale for 4, hold for 4, exhale for 4, and then hold for 4. So breathing control technique. This is a very good practice, deep breathing. And you really invite the breath all the way into the belly. So whenever we are feeling overwhelmed and stressed about the external noises, it's important to quiet your inside, your inner world. It's important to quiet that. Kasi whenever things are getting noisy in the outside, we allow that to affect us and then it gets noisy inside. So what we do is we don't let the external affect us. First, we center ourselves. So I understand it's easier said than done, but this is why it's called a practice. Yun yung tanong, di ba? What are the practices? But that's why we call it practice. Because we do it slowly. And we can't expect results like that. But I promise you, you set your timer 10 to 15 minutes and Jen, just focus on the breath. Don't focus on the mind. The mind will play tricks on you. This is normal. I'm not saying that the mind is bad. It's just that we are wired that way. When things are happening negatively, we tend to focus on the negative. And then we spiral. And that's not good. So when we meditate, when we breathe, we suddenly remember that we are strong enough to think of a solution whenever things get overwhelming. And the breath is also a beautiful reminder that you come from God. Because who is making you breathe? Hindi ka naman naka-plug, di ba, na parang cellphone. It's an invisible plug that's connected to God. That's why we have to breathe, we have to sit, we have to relax ourselves. Because nothing will happen if you panic. Especially when things are getting overwhelming, walang matutulong ang stress. And I think one example that I can give is when there was yes, intimidating, and it is very weird if lalo na pag hindi mo siya natatry pa and hindi ka pa consistent in your practice, it's something that is foreign, alam mo yun, something that we really have not yet parang really studied or parang experienced much of here in the Philippines. That's why in our community, Meditate with Maxine, we really like to create events so we can invite more people to join us. But basically, I would agree, meditation is a weird practice at the beginning. It is something that you really don't understand yet. But it's something that you have to experience for yourself because everyone's experience is different. So meditation, I thought it was to quiet the mind completely or to stop your thoughts from coming. That's not true. Meditation is not, the goal of meditation is not to control your thoughts because that's impossible. Your thoughts will naturally pop up one by one. And mabuti pa nga if your thoughts are coming, it means your mind is working. But what I would say is, don't believe all your thoughts because they're not all true. You know, sometimes your thoughts can come and it's just a random thought. So why do you have to let that thought affect you so much? So what meditation taught me and how I got into it actually, I was experiencing anger issues. And at that time, I was getting angry na talaga at myself. Because what would happen was, I was around 28, 29, around 2018, I would get angry, I would explode. Sorry, mga 31 na pala ako at that time. So I would explode and then I would get angry, and then I would apologize to the people that I shouted at, and then 2 weeks later, uulat na naman. Sorry. Yung konting pitik lang, naiirita na ako, tapos sasabog, and then wala rin nagagawa yung sorry ko. Kasi paulit-ulit. And I think that happens to most of us, right? Ang hirap baguhin eh. Ang hirap baguhin ng mga impulse reactions natin, ng mga default settings. Ang hirap baguhin. And so, at that time, I was already practicing yoga. And I would have to say that I got into yoga because of my what do you call this? I really couldn't handle my emotions very well. And I got into yoga because I wanted an exercise that could really help me keep my body fit, but at the same time, release anything that I need to release. And then, because of yoga, I was getting angry. I had episodes. And then I started to think to myself, what is the opposite of exploding? What is the opposite of getting angry? It's sitting down and just being quiet in the corner, di ba? Pagbata tayo, sit in the corner. Pag nagkaka-trauma tayo, pag nagkaka-ano tayo, tantrum, face the wall, face the corner. I think lahat tayo, dinaanan yan. Okay? So, yun pala yun. Parang whenever you're going through something, sit, breathe, ramdamin mo kung ano yun. And so, ako lang nag-isip. Sabi ko, ano yung kabaligtaran ng palaging nagagalit? Try ko kaya yung meditation. Walang nagsabi sa akin. More of nakikita ko lang siya because nga nag-yoga na ako. Tapos nakikita ko yung ibang yoga teacher nagme-meditate. Sabi ko, ba't kaya? Ano yan? And then when I started experiencing my own problems with my emotions, I sat down and I started meditating. And at the beginning, it was really hard. Kasi 5 minutes pa lang hindi ka na mapakali. Diba? Tapos kung gustuhin mo nang tumayo. So I started doing this, I subscribed to Calm.